Understanding what research is available for patients and families impacted by Huntington's disease can be overwhelming and confusing. This video will provide information about what types of research are available to people in the HD community and how you may access it. Participating in research is a personal decision, so we hope this video will help inform your choices. Research is very important to the HD community. Without research, scientists can't find treatments and increase our knowledge of Huntington's disease. No matter what type of research you take part in, every bit of participation is extremely important and helpful. There are three common types of HD research. The most well-known type of research is a clinical trial. Participation in a clinical trial may involve taking a study drug or a placebo to see if it meets a goal decided by the study team. This goal might be to determine if the drug is safe for people, what dosage of the drug is appropriate, or if it reduces a specific symptom. These trials can be time-consuming and may require several visits to a HD clinic over a year or two. There will likely be a lot of tests and procedures over that time. This is to properly measure if the drug is safe and if it does what researchers hope it is supposed to do. It is important to remember that there may be emotional challenges when taking part in a clinical trial. Some participants are understandably hopeful the study drug might be an effective treatment. Sometimes, the goals of the study drug are not met. This can cause a trial to end without an approved treatment. This can be hard to accept for participants, especially after putting so much hope into the trial's success. It is important to note if a clinical trial ends without an approved treatment, it still adds to our understanding of HD. If a drug does show promise, however, this might mean scientists are one step closer to treatments. It can also mean participants who took part in the clinical trial may be able to receive the drug before it is officially approved. Participation in clinical trials depends on inclusion and exclusion criteria based on the goal of the trial. Each trial has specific criteria. Participants need to talk to each drug studies team from each trial to determine if they meet the criteria. Clinical trials are usually only available in select HD sites around the world. These sites are chosen based on if the site has everything needed for the trial, such as clinical trial equipment, staff, and enough people who are eligible to participate. Unfortunately, some countries that don't have the resources needed to conduct a study may not have access to as many clinical trials. For more on how clinical trials work, watch HDYO's video, An Insight into Drug Development and Clinical Trials. Another type of research study is called an observational study. Observational studies observe or watch people and collect information over time. These types of studies don't require participants to take any study drug or placebo. As a result, observational studies are usually less demanding. They can also be much more accessible for HD families to take part in together. Many studies are open to the whole community, including people at risk, people who have tested positive or negative, partners, and caregivers. Observational studies are very beneficial for scientists wanting to learn about how people live and cope with HD. In the HD community, the biggest observational study is called Enroll HD. This study takes place around the world and involves one visit to an HD research site each year. Enroll HD does require a blood sample, but for most of the study visit, participants fill out questionnaires, complete tasks, and answer questions. Each study visit lasts about 1 to 2 hours. Currently, over 20,000 participants from HD families participate in Enroll HD. Enroll HD has taught researchers a lot about HD. More information, including participating locations, can be found at enroll-hd.org. Some other significant observational studies in the HD community include HD Clarity and Prevent HD. To find out more about these types of studies, HDYO also has a video about young people taking part in an observational study. Finally, surveys and registries are another important type of research. This type of research can help scientists learn more about how HD impacts people's lives. Many surveys and registries can be done online, making them easier to do on your own time. HDYO has a global registry called Join HD. It was created for patients and caregivers impacted by juvenile onset HD. To understand unmet needs of JOHD community and encourage researchers to focus more attention to JOHD. So, how do you find what research may be available to you? A good place to start is to meet with your HD clinic or medical team. They can talk to you about options as well as connect you with different research opportunities. There are also resources available online called Trial Finder. which help people find research opportunities. One trial finder site is available through the Huntington's Disease Society of America, and another is through the European Huntington Association. HDYO also has research updates on our website. Visit hdyo.org and click Research. Another option is to contact your local HD association. Many of these HD advocacy groups have information posted on their websites about what research is available in their area. We hope you found this video useful. If you have any questions about research participation, HDYO is here to help. We would like to thank our sponsors for their support.